Hello friends, in previous videos we have studied what is the need of the condenser. We have also studied what is the various types of condenser. So in this video we are going to study one such type of condenser, that is direct contact condenser. Now the direct contact condensers are basically of the following three types. First is spray condenser. Second is barometric condenser and third is jet condenser. So let us study these condensers in detail. Now in case of a spray condenser, the cooling water is sprayed directly on the steam. So steam, by mixing with the cold water, it gets condensed. Now the exhaust steam from the turbine at the state 2 mixes with the cooling water at state 5. To produce the saturated water at the state 3, which is pumped to state 4 as shown in figure below. So let us see this in the diagram. So here figure shows the schematic flow diagram of the direct contact spray condenser. So if we see, the steam from the turbine is let in the condenser, where it gets condensed, then it is given to the plant feed system. Also from the dry cooling tower, supply is given to the condenser, and these cycles keep on repeating. Now the TS diagram corresponding to figure A is as shown in figure B. So here we can see there are the various states 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and again 2S. Now the part of the condensate is equal to the turbine exhaust flow is sent back to the plant as the feed water. Now the remainder is cooled in a dry cooling tower, that is in state 5 as we have seen in the figure, and is then sprayed on the turbine exhaust. Since the cooling water mixes with the steam and the part of condensate is also used as the feed water, the water must be of the high quality. So in the geothermal or OTEC, that is ocean thermal energy conversion plant, only the vacuum is required in order to maintain in the condenser and no feed water is needed. But in case of thermal power plant, we require the feed water. Hence the mixture at state 4 can be discarded. Now for the spray type of condensers, a mass balance and an energy balance can be given by the following equations. Now W2 is equal to W4, similarly W3 is equal to W2 plus W5. Hence W2H2 plus W5H5 is equal to W3H3. Now from this equation we can write, W5 divided by W2 is equal to H2 minus H3 divided by H3 minus H5. Let it be equation number 1. Now as the H2 minus H3 is much greater than the H3 minus H5, the circulating water is now much greater than the steam flow. Now in the barometric condenser, as shown in figure C, the cooling water is made to fall on the series of baffles to expose the large surface area for the steam, which is fed from below to come in the direct contact. Now the steam condenses and the mixture falls on the tailpipe to the hot oil below. Now by the virtue of this static head, the tailpipe compresses the mixture to the atmospheric pressure. Therefore, P atmosphere minus P condensed is equal to delta PF is equal to PGH. Let it be equation number 2. Now let us see what are the various parameters in this equation. Where P is equal to density of mixture, then height, that is H is equal to height of the tailpipe, and delta PF is equal to pressure drop due to friction. So the figure C shows schematics of direct contact condensers, that is barometric and diffuser or jet. So this is the barometric and this is for the diffuser. So for the low values of delta PF, H is around 9.5 meter. Now the higher value of H corresponds to higher value of friction. So the friction can be lowered by increasing the tailpipe diameter, which results in tall and heavy system. Now in the jet condenser, the height of the tailpipe is reduced by replacing it with the diffuser. This is as shown in figure C. So the diffuser will help raising the pressure in a short distance as compared to the tailpipe. Now the spray type condenser, non-condensable gases are usually removed with the steam jet air ejector. So in this way, we have studied the direct contact condensers. Thank you friends for watching this video. Stay tuned with Ekeeda and do subscribe our channel Ekeeda. Thank you.